Now we will see there are certain special cases of multiple images. If we are seeing our image in the two mirrors, these are the two mirrors and these are reflecting surface. Here is the object. From this object, one ray goes like this and come back like this. We see the image number one. One goes like this and comes back like this, and we see that image here. This is image number two. Here was the image number one, just like by the rules of plane mirror. But now see, for this image for this ray goes in this direction, and here by the rules it is reflected like this. From here it is reflected by the rules and come to our eyes. If it happens like this, then we see an image in this line. And where is that image? How much is this distance? This distance you add up here and you see an image here. This image we observe here. Now, there may be another ray which is going in this direction. It is reflect, oh, this we have seen. Okay, the one which is going in this direction, this is reflected here. And from here, this is reflected in this direction and comes to our eye, and we see an image over here. So in this way, there are multiple images seen by keeping two mirrors at certain angle theta. How many these mirrors will be? How many these images will be? 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. For this, we have done very minute calculations, and you can simply remember the result of it, that number of images m is given by a formula: 360 upon theta minus 1, and another formula, n is equal to 360 upon theta. How there are two formulas? This formula is to be applied when 360 upon theta is even. This is to be applied when 360 upon theta is odd. Okay, that means 360 upon theta, if it comes to even, then that will not be the number. You have to decrease it by 1 so that it becomes an odd number. Similarly, this n, if it is already odd, then this is the answer. Why this happens? Because in multiple images, at the end, if the images formed are even, then there will be two images which will overlap each other, and that will appear to be one. So in our total count, one image become less. This one is less because of overlapping of two images at one places. This we have observed by very minute drawings. So you can remember it this way. Now let us test it. If there are two mirrors and they are making angle of 120 degree, this 120 degree, then number will be equal to 360 upon 120 minus 1. So 360 upon 120 is 3, that is odd. If it is odd, then we have to take only this formula and 3 images. So we will be able to see 3 images here. We have to put it somewhere here. One image will be from here, one image from here, and one by the multiple reflections. And the multiple reflection, the ultimate image will be only one, because two images will overlap on each. That will be one. So there will be total 3 images this way. Now, if the angle is 90 degree, if this is 90 degree, then at a suitable place we stand and we see the number of images: 360 upon 90. this is even number, so this will be applied, minus 1, that is equal to again 3. So even if this angle is 90 degree, we will be able to see maximum 3 images. So please remember this formula. So images, number of images will always be odd. They will never be even, and they are controlled by this formula. If this odd number comes, it is fine. If this is an even number, then please decrease it by 1. So that is the multiple images, what we can see by this angle. So we have seen certain examples for a plane mirror, and in the next lecture we will start if the mirror is not a plane but a curved mirror. Now, what is a curved mirror? How it does behave? That we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.